Okay.
You read the translation of the song. When the eastern horizon becomes tinged with the redness that heralds the rising of the sunrise, the jewel among the brahmanas, Lord Gorsundar, immediately awakened. Taking his devotees with him, he journeyed through the towns and villages of Nadia. The madangas resounded, tatai, tatai, and the jajas, large metal kartals that look like small cymbals, in that kirtan played in time. Lord Gauranga's golden form slightly trembled in ecstatic love of God, and his foot bells jingled. Lord Chaitanya called out to the townsfolk, "You spend your nights uselessly sleeping, and your days decorating your bodies. Now just fill your mouths with the holy names. Mukunda, Madhava, Yadava, and Hari, chanting without offense. You've achieved the rare human body. Don't you care for this gift? If you do not worship the darling of Mother Yashoda now, great sorrow awaits you at the time of your death. With every rising and setting of the sun, a day passes and is lost. When then do you remain? When then do you remain idle and not serve the Lord of the heart?" Why then? "You should understand this essential fact. Life is temporary and filled with various kinds of miseries. Therefore, carefully take shelter of the holy name and remain always engaged in his service as your eternal occupation. Desiring to bless all living entities, the sweet name of Krishna has descended to this material universe and shines like the sun in the sky of the heart, destroying the darkness of ignorance. Drink the pure nectar of the holy name of Krishna and thus satisfy the soul of Bhaktivinoda. There is nothing except the holy name within all the 14 worlds." Can you do Kotamwa?
Even 他带着他的奉献者 行遍乡间走访 Nadia的城镇和村庄， Mridanga鼓发出 Tatai Tatai的回响， 饶果有节奏敲击着， 祖格朗嘎金色的身躯因沉浸在对神心醉神迷的爱中而轻微颤抖颤抖， 脚铃也随之叮当作响，主持干的对居民们呼唤着，你们把你们夜晚的时间浪费在无用的睡眠上，用白天的时间装饰你们的身体，现在该用Kunda、Madhava、Yadava和Hari这些圣名的震荡填充你们的嘴了，不冒犯的吟诵吧，你们得到了稀有的人体， 你们不在乎这礼物吗？如果你们现在不侍奉耶稣的宠儿，巨大的悲痛就会在死亡到来时等着你们。太阳的每一次升起和落下就是一天的过去了，损失了。你们为什么还保持无所事事的状态，不愿侍奉心中的至尊主呢？人生苦短暂， 了解这基本的事实吧，所以把脱离于圣名，一直忙于为他服务，当作你们唯一的职责。因为想要祝福所有的灵魂， Krishna 甜美的名字降临到物质世界，此时正如太阳般在内心的天空中闪耀，驱散愚昧的黑暗。喝饮 Krishna 圣名的纯粹甘露，
满足了Bhaktivinoda的灵魂，在全部十四个世界中，除了圣名，别无其他。Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
namaskrityam
narayanam namaskrityam
naram chaiva narottamam
naram chaiva narottamam
devim sarasatim vyasam
devim sarasatim vyasam
tato jayamudiraye
tato jayamudiraye
nasta preshu babadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtaki
Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtaki.
We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter Number 60, entitled Krishna Tisis Rukmini, Text Number 44.
跟着我的一起阅读圣典博雅瓦坛第十篇第六十章主 Krishna 戏弄 Rukmini 皇后第44世节
Tashya
Tashya
Shur
Shur
Achuta
Achuta
Nipa
Nipa
Bhavato Padishta
Bhavato Padishta
Srinam
Griheshu
Tara Go Swa Vidala Vritya
Yat
Arna
Mulam
Hari Hari Karsana
Hari Karsana
Nopayayad
Nopayayad
Yashmat
Yashmat
Kata
Kata
Mridha
Mridha
Virincha
Virincha
Sab Sabashu
Sabashu
Gita
Gita
Tashyo Shura Chuta Nripa Pabato Padishta
Tashyo Shura Chuta
Srinam Griheshu Karako Swabhidala Vritya
Srinam Griheshu Karako Swabhidala Vritya
Yakarna Mulam Hari Karshana No Payayad
Yakarna Mulam Hari Karshana No Payayad
Yashmat Katam Ritha Varincha Subhasukita
Yashmat Kanta Rita Virincha Sabhasukita
Tashya Shura Chuta Nripa Bhavato Padishta
Tashya Shura Chuta Nripa Bhavato Padishta
Srinam Griheshu Karako Swabhidala Vritya
Srinam Griheshu Karako Swabhidala Vritya
Yakarna Mulam Adikarshana No Payayad
Yakarna Mulam Adikarshana No Payayad
Yashmat Kata Mridham Virincha Sabhasa Gita
Yusmakata
Vrita Vrita Svasa Gita Tashya Shurachuta Nripa Bhavato Padishta
Tashya Shurachuta Nripa Bhavato Padishta
Srinam Griheshu Srinam Griheshu Kara Gochara Vidala Vritya
Srinam Griheshu Kara Gochara Vidala Vritya
Yat Karna Mulam Hari Karshana No Payayad
Yat Karna Mulam Hari Karshana No Payayad
Yasmat Kata Mridha Varincha Sabhasu Gita
Yasmat Kata Mridha Varincha Sabhasu
Gita Tasya Shura Chitanrupa Vavato Padishta Asya Surachitaya Prabhavata Padisa.
Asya Surachitaya Prabhavata Padisa.
Srinam Grahe Sukara Goswa Vidana Vidya.
Srinam Grahe Sukara Goswa Vidana Vidya.
Yatkana Mulana Antarsanana Payaya.
Tashya,
Tashya,
of her,
of her,
Siu, let them become the husbands. Achyuta,
Achyuta,
O infallible Krishna,
O infallible Krishna, O
Nripa,
Nripa,
kings,
Guomaman,
Bhavata,
Bhavata,
by you,
baby,
Upadishta,
Upadishta,
mentioned,
Srinam,
of women,
Griheshu,
in the homes, Kara, as asis,
Go,
oxen,
Niu,
Shwa, dogs, Vidala,
cats.
Britya, and slaves.
Yet.
Whose?
Karna.
Of the ear.
Ardo.
Mulam.
The core.
Zhongxi.
Ari. Your enemies.
Karshana.
Of you who vex.
Never.
Upayayat.
Come near.
Yashmat.
Concerning you.
Kata.
Discussions.
Mridha.
Of Lord Shiva.
Virincha.
And Lord Brahma.
Sabashu. In the scholarly assemblies. Gita.
Sung.
Translation. O infallible Krishna, let each of the kings you named become the husband of a woman whose ears have never heard your glories, which are sung in the assemblies of Shiva and Brahma. After all, in the households of such women, these kings live like asses, oxen, dogs, cats, and slaves.
一个耳朵从没听过你荣耀的女子的丈夫吧，那荣耀被在希瓦和布拉玛的集会中唱诵，终究在这些女子的家庭中，这些国王们活得像孺子、公牛、狗、猫和奴隶一样。
Purport. According to Srila Sridhar Swami, these fiery words of Queen Rukmini's are a response to Lord Krishna's opening statement found in text 10 of the chapter. The Supreme Lord has said, "My dear princess, you were sought after by many kings as powerful as the rulers of planets. They were all abundantly endowed with political influence, wealth, beauty, generosity, and physical strength." According to Sridhar Swami, Queen Rukmini here speaks with anger, pointing her index finger at the Lord. She compares the so-called great princes to asses because they carry many material burdens, to oxen because they are always distressed while performing their occupational duties, to dogs because their wives disrespect them, to cats because they are selfish and cruel, and to slaves because they are servile in family affairs. Such kings may appear desirable to a foolish woman who has not heard or understood the glories of Sri Krishna. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti adds that such kings are like asses because their wives sometimes kick them, like dogs because they behave inimically towards outsiders in order to protect their homes, and like cats because they eat the remnants left by their wives.
根据Srila Swami Rukmini王后这些斥的言语是对主Krishna在本章世界时的开篇陈述的回应。至尊主曾说：“我亲爱的公主，你被众多如星球的控制者那般有力的国王追求，他们都赋予高度的政治影响力、大量的财富、美貌、慷慨和身体的力量。” 依据Srila Swami Rukmini王后在这里怀着怒气讲话，用他的食指指着主。他将所谓的伟大王子们比喻为驴子，因为他们承载着许多物质的负担；比喻为牛，因为他们在履行父定职责时总是很苦恼；比喻为狗，因为他们的妻子不尊敬他们。 比喻为猫，因为他们自私而冷酷；比喻为奴隶，因为他们是家庭事务的奴仆。这样的国王可能对没有听说或理解Sri Krishna荣耀的愚蠢女人来说是可遇的。圣Vishwanath Chakravarti补充说，这样的国王像孺子。
Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakha Nitam Sya. Hey Krishna Karana Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagapate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gaurange Radhe Vrindavanishwari Vrishabhanu Sudhe Devi. Panchakaupatarubhyascha Kripasindubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Nama Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing about the affairs of Lord Krishna in his household and life while he's residing in Dwarka. So in Dwarka, Lord Krishna has his wives residing there, and he has nice arrangements for each of them. And it said that his favorite wife amongst all of his wives, his favorite wife was Sri Rukmini. So Lord Krishna took the time to spend some joking words with her.
So Krishna
And it's very interesting for us to see how Queen Rukmini responds to these joking words of Lord Krishna. Krishna and Rukmini at this particular point, it said they were already grandparents, but Krishna was joking with Rukmini and he told her that, you know, I'm not really worthy to be your husband. And he said that when I kidnapped you at that time, your father and brother, they'd arranged many very qualified men to come who would have made a good husband for you.
父王跟你的哥哥已经安排了非常有资格的国王，他们就是更有资格成为你的丈夫。
I feel like maybe I did the wrong thing. I shouldn't have got in the way. I shouldn't have kidnapped you.
所以我觉得我做错了，我其实不应该中途出现，然后把你带走。
I should have left you to these other men.
我应该将你交到这些男人的手上。
So Queen Rukmini is replying to these words and described here that her anger has been awakened by these words.
那在这里描述到，鲁宾女王听到这些话的时候，就激起了她这个怒气。
Right, women can get very angry sometimes. So Queen Rukmini is no different.
于是有时候可以非常的愤怒，然后鲁宾女王后也一样。
Said hell has no fury like the wrath of a woman.
Wrath, like anger.
Hell has no fury like the wrath of a woman.
Hell has no
fury. 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 It's similar to wrath.
Hell, 就是那个地狱，就好像这个就是圣怒，就是怒火一样，怒火 ，like fire.
Hell does not have that kind of wrath which a woman has.
所以地狱也没有这个女人这种怒火，地狱不存在，所以这个怒火比地狱还可怕。
There was a very famous book. Novel written about that, you know.
那有一本小说是讲这个事情的，很著名的小说。
They're all laughing, they all know. They can get very angry.
所以女士们有时候可以非常的愤怒。
So Rukmini is a bit angry. She's pointing at Krishna, you know, and she.
然后这里 Rukmini 就怀着这个怒气，然后他就指着 Krishna。
Now of course Rukmini, she's one of, she has great love for Krishna. She's a prema bhakti. She's achieved the highest level of love for Krishna.
嗯，当然那种，当然 Rukmini 王后呢对 Krishna 是怀着巨大的奉爱，她是达到了这个 prema bhakti 就最高的最崇高的对 Krishna 的爱。
Krishna's telling her that, you know, you should have went with these other men, you know, that I'm not a good husband for you.
那个是哪个？我跟你说，你应该跟这些男人在一起，我不配做你的丈夫。
So Rukmini is saying, you think I would go with those men?
然后 Rukmini 就说，你以为我会跟这些男人在一起吗？
Those people, they're not even men, they're more like animals.
这些人呢，他是男人呢，他都不像是人了，他们更像是一头动物。
And she describes what kind of animals they are like.
然后在这里，他就描述到他们像什么样的一些动物。
Yeah, they're like donkeys.
驴子。
Right, they carry heavy loads.
那就是要载着很重的那个物质的负担。
Now, Queen Rukmini is describing these men who are actually kings in the material world.
Rukmini 这里描述的这些男人其实是在物质世界里面的国王。
But she's looking down on them.
但是她看不起他们。
She can look down on them because she understands Lord Krishna's supreme position.
她之所以能够看不起他们，因为她明白，她理解到 Krishna 自尊的地位。
When she looks at Krishna and considers Lord Krishna, and then she thinks about these men,Then she thinks these so-called kings, they're just like animals.
所以当她看到 Krishna, 将 Krishna 跟这些国王相比的时候，这些国王就显得好像动物一样。
These men, so-called kings of the material world, they have to struggle to maintain their family, to maintain their kingdom.
这些物质世界所谓的国王，其实也就是保护他们的国王啊，家庭也在苦苦挣扎。
Just like the donkey has to carry the heavy load.
就好像这个驴子需要承载许多的负担货物。
The donkey so foolish. Everywhere there is grass, but he's thinking if I don't carry the heavy load, I won't get any grass.
所以这些驴子非常的愚蠢，其实周围都是草，但是他们心里面想，我除非，要承载这些货物，否则的话没有办法能够吃的草。
So the kings in the same way they struggle to maintain their kingdom.
所以这些国王也一样，为去维系他们的王国非常的苦恼。
And then she said they're like oxen because oxen is always distressed.When doing their duties.
他又将这些国王比喻为牛，因为他们在履行复利职责的时候总是很苦恼。
So material life is like that.
物质的生命就是这样。
So much distress in the course of everyday life.
在每一天的生活里面都充满了这个苦恼。
Working a job, and you're always worried. You always have to worry. Maybe I'm not going to get.Maybe they don't want me. Maybe they'll fire me. Maybe I'll get made redundant, paid off.
所以就是工作的时候，常常就会担忧，就说可能他们会把我就辞掉，然后可能不给我发工资。
No, you have to work. You have to put up with so many nasty people when you work with in the offices in material life. You have to work with so many people who are not always very friendly or nice.
在办公室工作的地方里面，常常要面对忍受这些可能不太友善的人。
And you have to work for people who are often wicked and sinful.
那也要跟一些一般都是充满了罪恶，还有非常的狡猾的人。
And they're usually also miserly.
他们也是非常的吝啬的。
So.This is the material life, just like the oxes suffer so much distress.
这就是物质的生活，就是好，就好像那些牛一样，他们要需要受苦。
And then she said that these so-called kings are like dogs.
然后我跟你往后说到，这些国王又好像狗一样。
Because the dog, says the dogs are never respected by their female partner.
就有种说法，就是说，就是狮酒女的酒狗啊狗，他们不尊重他们的丈夫。
You can see the dogs often. You see a couple of dogs, you know, they're fighting with each other, barking and biting each other.
有时候我看见一群狗会聚集在一起，然后在那个吠啊叫啊。
So these kings of the material world are in a similar position to the dogs.
所以这些物质世界的国王跟这些狗差不多。
The wives will be complaining to them all the time.
然后妻子们会一直的跟他们抱怨。
Finding fault with them and saying bad words, nasty words to them.
跟他们说一些不好听的话，然后就会找他们错处。
There was a great king called Muchikunda.
有一位伟大的国王叫 Muchikunda.
He was born in the dynasty coming from Maharaj Ikshvaku.
他是Maharaj Ikshvaku 的这个皇系里面就是的后裔。
So he was enlisted by the demigods to go and fight on behalf of the demigods against the demons.
所以呢，他被这个半神人的赋予这个职责，就是去跟这个恶魔作战。
And he satisfied the demigods with all of his bravery and his great fighting. So the demigods were very pleased with him. They offered him a benediction.
那他最后就是战胜这些恶魔，半神人就觉得非常的满意，就给他一个祝福。
But demigods cannot give liberation because they're just demigods, they're not supreme. Only the supreme Lord can give liberation.
但是半神人没有办法给予解脱的祝福，只有至尊主才能够。
But they can give any kind of material benediction.
他们能够给予任何物质的祝福。
So Maharaj Muchikunda asked them, he said, "You know, I've been fighting for you for a long time. I really want to have a good rest." So please bless me that I can take rest without disturbance.
所以穆奇昆达他就有一个请求，就说我已经坐在一段很长的时间，我很累，我想有一个大休息，然后就没有人能够骚扰我的情况下。
So the demigods blessed him that you can take a rest as long as you like, and if anybody will disturb you when you open your eyes.You will burn them to ashes.
所以这个半神就给他这样一个祝福，你可以喜欢休息多长时间就多长时间，然后没有人会打扰你。如果有人来打扰你的话，你被打扰的时候眼睛张开，然后就会把那个人烧成灰烬。
So Muchikunda thought this sounds very nice. He lay down in a cave and went to sleep.
所以Muchikunda他就觉得这个安排非常好。他就躺下来就开始睡觉了。
So Lord Krishna was aware of this, and at one point, when Lord Krishna was fighting a battle against Jarasandha and another demon called Kalayavana, at this part, Lord Krishna left the battlefield.
所以Krishna 跟 Jarasandha 作战的时候，他离开了那个战场，然后还有意外一个恶魔叫。
And then that's when Lord Krishna left the battlefield. He did his ranchur pastime.
他就上演他的 ranchur 这个笑时光，他离开，从那个战场里上面逃离。
We were hearing about ranchur a few days ago.
我们几天前听到 Krishna 这个名字叫 ranchur.
Ranchur is the name of Krishna. It means one who leaves the battlefield. It's actually a dishonor to leave the battlefield, but Krishna, for Krishna, is just this pastime.
所以 Rancha 的意思就是逃离战场的人，但是一个人如果逃离战场的话，是一种就是不光荣的事情。但是这个是 Krishna 的笑时光。
So Krishna left the battlefield, and this demon Kalayavana went after him.
当 Krishna 离开这个战场的时候，这个恶魔 他的 Yavana 就追着他。
And Krishna went into the cave where this Muchikunda was laying sleeping.
所以 Krishna 就进到这个山洞里面，这个 Muchikunda 他在睡觉。
And Kali Yavana thought when he came in the cave, he saw this person laying on the floor, and he thought it was Krishna.
当 Kali Yavana 进到这个山洞的时候，他看见有一个人躺在地上，他以为是 Krishna.
So he kicked him.
他就用脚去踢他。
So Maharaj Muchikunda opened his eyes and he burned the demon to ashes.
然后 Maharaj Muchikunda 他就把眼睛打开，然后就把这个恶魔给烧成灰烬。
Krishna made use of this.Maharaj Muchikunda to kill this demon.
So Krishna, he is using Muchikunda to kill this demon.
If Krishna had to kill Kali Yavana, Kali Yavana would get liberation. But he was not qualified.
If Krishna 亲自把 Kali Yavana 杀死的话，他就会得到解脱，但是他还没有这个资格。
So Krishna arranged for Muchikunda to.
So Krishna 安排了 Muchikunda 来做这个事情。
So then Muchikunda.Saw Krishna, and then when he saw Krishna, then he was puzzled. He wondered, who is this?
Muchikunda 看到 Krishna 的时候，他就觉得非常的疑惑。他说，这是谁？
And he was asking Krishna about. He wanted to understand who this person was because he could understand he was a very unique, very divine personality.
他知道这位人物肯定是非常的。特别的非常的神圣的一位人物，他在询问究竟他是谁。
But before he asked who Krishna was, he first of all introduced himself.
在他提问之前，他先去介绍自己。
It's a proper etiquette that when you meet somebody, you don't just ask them who are you. You first of all introduce who you are, and then you can say I am so and so, and then who are you?
所以这个是以我们去跟一个人见面的时候，我们不会第一时间问你是谁，而是我们会先介绍自己。
So Maharaj Muchikunda was introducing himself, and he was explaining how he was born in a family coming from the line of Maharaj Ikshvaku, and how he went to fight for the demigods.
所以 Muchikunda 他就介绍自己，说到自己是来自于这个Maharaj Ikshvaku 的这个家族，然后他跟这些恶魔。
And he also told Lord Krishna how he was a great king and he enjoyed in the palace as a king. He enjoyed all kinds of sense gratification.
他也跟 Krishna 说了，他在那个王宫里面，他是一个国王去享受。
But he described how whenever he wanted sense gratification, he would bow to his wives to beg sense gratification.
但是他说到他每一次想得到这个。感官享乐的时候，他都要顶拜他的妻子。
This way, although he's a king and fighting a battle and people are bowing to him, but when he comes before his wife, he has to bow to his wife.
所以这个国王他在这个战场上面，所有人都顶拜他，但是他来到他妻子的面前，他要顶拜他的妻子。
So this way is like dogs.
所以就这样，他们就好像狗一样。
And then these people are also described to be like cats because they're selfish and cruel.
这些国王也比喻为猫，因为他们自私而冷酷。
Cats are often also very envious of each other.
猫呢，他们一般就会非常的嫉妒对方。
And so Queen Rukmini, she said.She's describing that these men, these so-called men that you wanted me to marry, they're just like cats. Also, they are also, they have the same quality as these cats.
Ukraine 这里就说你想我嫁给他们，就是这些国王们，这些男人呢，他们就好像猫一样。
Just like when the Pandavas married Draupadi, all the other kings were envious.
就好像当 Pandava 去朱巴迪的时候，其他的国王都非常的嫉妒。
All the other people envy each other. They say, even you're a king, you envy some other king.
就说你是国王，你还会嫉妒其他的国王。
People in that material world, nobody is satisfied with what they have.
在物质世界里面，没有人会为他们所拥有的东西感到满足。
So they're cruel and nasty with each other. in their dealings. They don't have good qualities.
所以他们对待别人的时候非常的冷酷，然后也很残忍。
Without being a devotee, you cannot have good qualities.
除非成为奉献者，不然的话没有办法有好的品质。
There's a Devi Sampad and Asuri Sampad. There's two kinds of people. There's the divine and there's the demoniac.
所以有两种人，一种人是恶魔属性的，另外一种是神圣的属性。
So those who are divine, those who are godly people, they're in the mode of goodness. They have the good quality.
神圣的人，他们是处于善良的属性，有善良的属性。
But those who are not devotees, they're influenced by the modes of passion and ignorance.
但是如果不是奉献者的话，他们会受到这个激情跟愚昧的属性所影响。
And that reflects in their actions, in their thinking, in their behavior, in their talking.
在他们的思想、行为、说话的方式上面会显现出来，展现出来。
And then.Queen Rukmini then said these people who are so-called kings, that they're like slaves to their wives.
然后 Rukmini 也说到这些国王，就好像奴隶一样。
They have to do everything. Just they always have to think of how to please their wife, what to do right to keep the wife happy.
他们总是要想着怎么取悦他们的妻子，让他们开心高兴。
So Queen Rukmini is understanding the nature of these materialistic men.
所以如米尼他深知这些物质的男人的他们的本性。
And she's telling Lord Krishna, how could you ever really expect me to marry anybody like that?
然后他就跟 Krishna 说，你怎么会期望？我会嫁给这些人吗？
Because Queen Rukmini said, anyone who's ever heard anything about Krishna, then they will never accept any of these other men. They can never marry.
Anyone who
has heard.
Yeah. 所以任何人，他们听过了你的荣耀的话，他们都不会选择这些国王。
Because they've heard about Krishna, so they can never be satisfied with any other man.
因为听到你的荣耀之后，就对这些国王就不会觉得感到满意了。
So in this way, Queen Rukmini is presenting her argument to Krishna.
所以就这样，Rukmini用这些论点去反驳 Krishna.
What began as a joke, Krishna was joking with Rukmini.
一开始只是Krishna 只是跟 Rukmini 说笑。
And Krishna was.He didn't. Well, we don't know. But we see how Rukmini reacts to these joking words of Krishna.
我们这里可以看到 Rukmini 王后是如何去回应 Krishna 这些说笑的话。
She took the opportunity to use everything which Krishna said to glorify Krishna.
她用每一个机会，就是 Krishna 所说的这些话语。作为一个机会去荣耀 Krishna.
Yeah, not only to glorify Krishna, but and by her glorifying Krishna, she's also showing her own glorious position as a great devotee.
去荣耀 Krishna, 她也去展示到她是一个如此光荣的一位奉献者。
She actually has understood Krishna's position.
她其实真正知道 Krishna 的地位。
And she's.Very powerfully defending her action in accepting the position of Krishna's wife.
所以她非常有力的去，有力的去，就是，反驳，然后就确立了她作为 Krishna 妻子的地位。
She's like nobody, any devotee, anyone who's ever heard about Krishna, they can never be happy.Can never accept anyone other than Krishna.
所以他说，所有听过 Krishna 荣耀的女子，她们都没有办法去接受其他的男人作为她们的丈夫。
These animals are often, they're also mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. These there's a verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam where these kind of animals are mentioned.
在《国家瓦塔》里面的另一些地方也有提到这些动物。
They mention hawks and dogs, camels and asses.
讲到
hawks means pig.
这个猪，骆驼 ，camel and
dogs,
狗
and asses.
还有犊子。
Those four. In the second canto, Srimad Bhagavatam, it said people who are like these animals, they will praise men of a similar nature.
就说到在《国要瓦坛》的第二篇里面讲到，如果人们就跟这些动物有同样的品质的话，他们就会去荣耀那些有相同品质的一些人。
Yeah, if someone is a big dog, then they will praise another dog, a bigger dog.
如果一个人是一只狗的话，然后他就会去赞美另外一只更大的狗。
Yeah, because they think, you know, they're a dog, they behave like a dog, and somebody is even a bigger dog than them, so they will respect, oh, he's a great dog, he's a big dog.
你就是他自己是一头狗嘛，就是好像狗一样。然后他看见另外一只，更就是大的狗的时候，他就会就是去赞美荣耀他。
So Prabhupada said politics is like that.
圣巴巴德说这些就是政治。
And especially democracy, when you have a democratic system, it's like that.
当你有这个民主的制度的时候，就会这样。
Yeah.People who are like dogs will select a big dog to be their leader.
那些跟狗一样的人，他们就会推举一个更大的一头狗作为他们的领袖。
Or somebody's a big pig, they will select the biggest pig.
如果他们是像猪一样的话，就推举一个更大的猪。
They cannot understand that. They don't see any fault in the behavior of these people.
这些人他们没有看，没有察觉到他们的行为的问题。
Because they think, well, I'm like that, so you know, he's like me, and he's better than me at doing all these things, so you know, he should be my leader.
我就是这样，然后他跟我也差不多，也比我做得更好，所以我应该推举他成为我的那个领导。
Because they've never heard, they've never appreciated the actual position of Krishna.
他们没有办法能够去欣赏 Krishna 真正的地位。
So they just follow some foolish, they elect some person to lead them.
他们就需要就找一些人，需要找一些人去带领他们。
Everybody needs to have someone to lead them. To, when they look up to a leader, they want someone to follow.
每个人都仰望一个领袖啊，去带领自己。
But they don't know what is actually the qualification.
但是他们不知道真正的资格是什么。
But Queen Rukmini, she knows.
Rukmini 王后她知道。
She understands Krishna's qualification.
她知道 Krishna 的资格。
She's defending her action in taking shelter.
他为他脱离于 Krishna 的，来，自己去，他在这里辩护。
And she said, Lord Krishna is even glorified by Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma.
在这里说到 ，Krishna 甚至是被 Shiva 和主 Brahma 所荣耀。
And these kings, these so-called kings, they're just like animals.
这些所谓的国王们就好像混，活的就好像，活的就像动物一样。
But the powerful person, the actual powerful leaders of the world in the universe, like Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma, they worship Lord Krishna.
但是在宇宙里面真正有力量的这些领袖，他们是荣耀 Krishna， 崇拜 Krishna。
So Queen Rukmini is defending her position and.She's also establishing the position of Lord Krishna.
所以 Rukmini 王后为她的 那个身份辩护，也去确立了为 Krishna 的地位而辩护。
This is a very nice chapter to go through. This chapter, verse by verse, is very good. It's a very nice chapter.
这一章节是非常好的，我们一节一节是这样去读。
We're very fortunate that we can have the Srimad Bhagavatam like this.
我们非常的有就是幸运能够有这样的一本博雅瓦坛。
And we can hear the whole pastime, one verse at a time.
我们能聆听整段的笑时光，每一次一节诗。
It seems very practically applicable, Maharaj. It seems very practically.Applicable.
Yes, it's practical.
所以这个知识是非常的实用的。
Okay. So Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki Premanande.
Yeah.